The thing is, a lot of people think I do stuff for shock value, but, you know, it's kind of like the bear shitting in the woods, and if nobody sees it, it doesn't happen. It's like, if nobody's around, I'm still fucking myself in the ass with a dildo, sticking a fucking 18-gauge needle into the head of my cock to get blood on paintings. I'm not doing it for shock value. My American hero is Geronimo. Legally, Geronimo is still classified as a terrorist. American culture uses the sexual image to sell things. I use the sexual image and sexual magic as a spiritual practice and a reclamation. So, going back to Geronimo, the marrying ritual is to replace Coyote's bones, which Coyote is the trickster, and to symbolically take back and reclaim Geronimo's bones to inspire other people to do ritual. A lot of people who are skull and bones may or may not necessarily believe in application of practical magic. But the psychological aspect is they're like, fuck you, we're in control here. You know, our people are going to be presidents just, you know, like the fucking monarchs in England. And I think I have a better understanding of ritual magic than they do. It's the wheel of confusion. Thus, you know, you get too drunk, you get confused, right? It spins, but it always comes back to this area when you spin it. Snake skin just kind of ended up not even necessarily part of the sculpture, but I need to like paint, try again. That's the joke. You spin it, I always keep, you know, try again. You know, whiskey knowledge, have another bottle, spin again, try again. You know, it's a perpetual thing. I can see why it's so oppressive on reservations. Young people have no fucking options at all. You know, Indian goes out and makes his own headdress, and it's like, it's appalling. He's like trying to destroy our culture. Meanwhile, you got these fucking Christian churches on the reservation. And it's commentary on alcohol. It's like not... The problem with alcohol is a spiritual problem. It's not just a chemical, genetic problem, especially with Native Americans. The white culture is devoid of spirituality. Alcohol, spirits, has an appeal to Native Americans. The problem with Native Americans and alcohol is not knowing how to use it, like psychedelics. So you can't sculpt, paint, whatever, it doesn't fucking matter. You can decide for yourself how you want to live, but you don't have to be a fucking master painter to do that. My paintings, for instance, I use a lot of sexual magic. My work is entirely sexuality. I like to masturbate when I paint. Chair in my studio with a dildo and a strap on, it doesn't make me a homosexual. But it doesn't make me a heterosexual either. It doesn't mean this is art. It looks good, it has aesthetic properties. It matches the painting. You know, people say you should do art to match their couch. I created something I could fuck myself with that matched my painting. It happens. Apache Gan dancers, crown dancers. They were part of a fertility ritual, puberty ritual, for Apache young girls coming of age. It was outlawed by the United States government until 1932. It was a spring rite. The government said, okay, now you can do your rituals, but you gotta do them on the 4th of July. So it was like a psychological warfare thing. Well, from my point of view, we have this culture that delegates tasks and demeans creativity. Our idea is, okay, you need to have a dishwasher. So this person's whole life is about washing dishes. You know, maybe like mixing some of that that attitude with the communal attitude, and the dishwasher can be a dishwasher on Tuesdays and go paint like most of the week or whatever. If we get away with this, we throw away this idea that everyone has to be a slave to this one thing. That's why it's a funny thing if you bring up careers to Indians on reservations, they just laugh at your career. Fuck that, that's like, that's a Eurocentric idea.